clearly not in government, but you're sitting, your party sits in the government with Naftali Bennett, very harsh words. He's actually pointing the finger directly at Abbas. So does the Israeli prime minister. Your party believes in a two-state solution, hopes for reconciliation, hopes to sit at the table. How can this help?
First of all, just want to send my condolences
of
to
course.
A family, and let's emphasize, a family of a border policeman, Assad, who's not Jewish. The member of the Palestinian Council talked about the Jewish exclusive civilization here, and here you have an example of someone who's not Jewish, who was serving in the border police, who was killed yesterday, and we send our condolences, and also we hope that everyone has a speedy recovery who was hurt yesterday. We in Yesh Atid as well, who do believe in two states or two people, who do believe we have to find a solution to the conflict, we also point a finger at the leadership on the Palestinian side in this situation. The moment that Yehuda Glick last week is shot, the notion that a condolence letter is sent to the terrorist who killed him, the notion that there is not a condemnation, the notion that even the fellow you had on the phone a moment ago says in the car attack last week, we think that maybe a Colombian visitor was killed. There was a three-month-old baby that was killed, and yes, there was a person from Ecuador who was killed as well. The facts are the facts. You heard Nasrallah before saying that we're somehow rising up against Al-Aqsa. We're not. The misinformation, and the term I have to use is a libel against us in terms of the situation, is
but isn't the fact that the status quo of Temple Mount was, you know, that there were talks about changing it, isn't the fact that throughout these scuffles you have soldiers coming to Temple Mount?
Sorry, we've made it very clear that the status quo is not going to change. There is no attempt to take over the Al-Aqsa Mosque. There is no attempt to limit in any way the Palestinian rights there. There is no initiative for us to change the Jewish status there. It's all incitement, and the incitement has to stop. The moment that incitement stops, the moment Abbas is not together with Hamas, who calls the person yesterday, the terrorist, a hero, we are completely willing to sit together. We need to be moving towards a resolution of the conflict. In order for that to happen, we call on President Abbas to denounce the partnership with Hamas, to condemn all acts of terrorism. We certainly would condemn any act of terrorism from the Jewish side. I do call on the Jewish side to also reduce the tensions, not to do anything to incite the other side. But at the moment, even we in Yesh Atid do say that President Abbas, his words and actions these last few days in particular, he is held accountable for what is happening.
When you said incitement on the Palestinian side, but you know, there's those who will argue that basically on the Israeli side, people buying houses in Silwan that is predominantly Palestinian, and we know the reason that those houses are being bought by Jews, that in itself is also an inciting move.
We for sure might take a step back and say that shouldn't be done, but to make a suggestion that somehow because of that in any way should somehow connect the dot to a person getting into a car and driving and killing people in cold blood is something which we do not accept. Should it not be done? It should not be done. Should we try to avoid raising the tensions? We should. But let's condemn murderers, let's condemn terrorism, let's get back to talking as people who want to resolve a conflict instead of what seems like on the other side, certainly people who want to inflame the conflict and certainly lend a hand to the killing of more innocent people. Remember, we have terrorism, we have terrorists, let's condemn them, and I call on President Abbas and everyone on the Palestinian side to do so. That is what ultimately will lead us to sitting together and hopefully resolving the conflict.
We have to remember that the President Abbas also caters to a group of people that's not just necessarily Israeli, also has to make
that. It takes a lot of courage, I agree.
But that's, you know, a discussion that we can continue. Thank you for joining us today, Knesset Minister Lipman, of course, on the phone, Dimitri Deliani on the phone from Jerusalem.